In the 1960s and 70s, many workers from the subcontinent were attracted to Oldham, a small town known for its cotton mills. The vision and determination was to create a better future for the next generation. The newly arrived Asian community, particularly from East and West Pakistan, purchased and established Oldham's first place of worship that would bring the community together for their spiritual and communal needs. It would go on to be the first Islamic center in Oldham, initially known as simply Oldham Mosque, and then Nusratul Islam Mosque.
Before 64, there were no mosques at all in Oldham, at all whatsoever. And if they were celebrating Eid, they were going out there hiring either the churches or we used to call a co-op. Then they come up with an idea, let's have a mosque. And the first mosque was, they come up with, was on to Churchill Street, number 16, I remember.
Which was a small terrace house with one room, because it was next to Anglican Church. We used it for about 12 months without planning permission, because the church would cover us and saying it's part of their extensions. It was really good community cohesion, if you like, at that time.
In 65, it was then owned and declared as the Nusratul Mosque in 1965.
The only reason we left Churchill Street was the government was going to knock down the whole street. We bought two houses on Hardy Street, Kersley Street corner. So that was even smaller than the Churchill Street. And we didn't have that many children. We're looking at maybe 80 to 100 children.
I thought about it, Allah Pak has made me a very good time. I was a class of children. There were groups in KD. There were three groups. There were three groups in the Sipari. So children also prayed.
We realized that the mosque was in danger of collapsing because of the cellar, the water been seeping into the cellar.
Jisle sade kol Hardy Street masjid si us waqt te sade kol koi paisa nahi si, only 14,000 pounds si jisle start masjid si shuru kiti hai. Fir Allah Pak ne na bada sade te karam kita.
We developed this mosque as a single floor, which is where we are sitting now. We realized that there was two sections of the community that was completely excluded from here, which was women and young people. So we decided that actually we need to expand on that. So we then decided we want to build a hall exclusively for women, which we just completed this Ramadan.
From such humble beginnings, Nusratul Islam Mosque has gone from strength to strength to become a pillar for the community. Its charitable efforts, education and strong voice for all sections of the community, particularly women and young people, has aided the current level of activity both in and out the mosque.
Every day if you come in, you will never find mosque empty. There'll always be something happening in our mosque.
I'm a volunteer for Human Aid. Alhamdulillah, with the help of Pitt and Nusratul Islam, we've managed to raise two full ambulances that will be going over to Syria.
These ambulances are going to Syria and they're going to help the children and families in Syria.
We only started off with only one ambulance, and alhamdulillah, the response was so amazing that we were able to fundraise 3-4 ambulances. This is part of the Unity Convoy.
We did the Ramadan food pack. Alhamdulillah, I think we reached more than 100 packs. They had items like oil and rice and tomato sauces. Knowing that we packed with our own hands and people are going to eat and people are going to survive off our hard work, of the little that we've done, knowing that, I think that was the reward in itself. We offer primary and secondary tuition. Secular education and Islamic education, they go hand in hand. We have this motto, the best in deen and the best in dunya.
You can do the reading shapes, you can play games.
This helps me to learn. It goes over the stuff that I've been learning in school.
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu classes take place every Saturday and Sunday. Girls classes on a Saturday, boys classes on a Sunday. It's nice to see that the children come in and they participate, and seeing the jiu-jitsu class as well, I've seen that my children really, really enjoy it. The classes are very fun. They get to learn and they get to enjoy themselves as well.
Kids are so eager to take part, and usually these kids who are taking part in our sessions are kids who usually wouldn't have the opportunity. Access to these things are very difficult for our children because they come from very poor backgrounds. Times we don't even make a profit on some of our activities. Many times we make a loss. In the last year, we've started football training sessions. Blessings, every second, so many
lessons, got me turning to the heavens. I'm really happy about my education and we do lots of fun activities.
Everyone's loving the relationship that they have with the masjid, and it's really important for us. We're making a really good effort, and you can see our community is essential.
The understanding for our community used to be is for our generation to read the Quran and finish the Quran, that's it. But what we are doing now on a daily basis is we deliver further education as well as the basic education.
The boys and girls, they spend over 10 years in a madrasa. So it's so important that that madrasa caters and it delivers the knowledge, the dini education to that child. In 2010, we had about 70 students, and now in 2017, alhamdulillah, we have 370 students. We have a waiting list of over 50 to 60. In the primary maktab, they would learn the basics.
Hadith, surahs, masail, kalimas, tajweed, masail, class, and I enjoy masjid.
The secondary maktab, they will be covering over a period of 6 years over 1,000 hadiths of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We want them to have sufficient knowledge of the deen.
When I was 5 years old, I visited Qaeda. Then from Qaeda, I've been going to us and higher, and I'm in FE class. I've been learning a lot in this mosque.
It's not a curriculum that we've taken from another place. So we've had to make this own. We've had to make this ourselves.
And the Bajis gives the exams at the end of the year, so they kind of know what we're on and what we're struggling with.
What I've seen is the shift is quite big. It's massive. The kind of curriculum now is more structured, and there's a lot more offered on it. There's a lot more covered. And also as well, the texts that are actually used are a lot more comprehensive as well.
I would say it's unique because we have the primary madrasa and we have the secondary madrasa. And this is why we have a 12-year syllabus.
Families, naturally, they outgrow. You know, we start off with one kid, two kids. We start off with a two-bedroom house. Eventually, nobody's going to be happy living with having three or four children and living in a small house.
Good education, it has certain demands, and part of that is having a conducive environment in which to be able to deliver the education.
Without the extra space, we won't be able to fulfill the dream, which is to have from year one up to year 12.
The overall cost just for this project is costing us £236,000. We have already got some of the money, I would say about £50,000. So you're talking about another £200,000 that we're raising.
Anybody who wants to donate to us should be confident that the money they donate to us will actually go toward the mosque.
In 9 months' time, this will be complete. If people see the work starting, we felt that, yeah, people will really realize what's going on. So donate and be part of this masjid.
Today, we face a choice to sit back or move forward. By moving forward, you will help shape the next generation as they navigate through what is arguably the most difficult time for Muslims in recent history. It is critical that this extension takes place and on schedule. So step forward and be a part of the next phase of this crucial development of the Nusratul Islam Mosque.